In this video, I will show you how to use terrain editing tools available with the Pro features of the app. Terrain editing techniques are the same for iOS, Windows, and macOS versions of Live Home 3D. For this tutorial, I will use a two-story house project, but you can use terrain tools for any house project you're working with. All the terrain work is usually done in the 2D view, while the 3D view is used mostly to preview the result. Now let's switch to the 2D view mode. The terrain editing tools can be found under the Site menu. As you can see, only Terrain Rectangular and Terrain Polygonal tools are active at the moment. Let's see what they do and how the rest of the tools can be activated. Once I select, say, the Terrain Rectangular tool, the warning dialog appears, telling me that I need to switch to the site level to edit the landscape around the house. I switch to the site level, and as you can see, the house plan view changes to outline. And now I can add terrain elements. As you may already know, switching between levels, as well as adding the roof, can always be done with the help of the Building Properties tab of the inspector. I will need this tab once I'm done with the terrain and need to get back to the ground floor. Note that if you select the house on site level, you may move it to any position, as well as rotate using the special handle. But we won't need this at the moment. The Terrain Rectangular tool, which I just activated, allows me to set the area where all landscape modeling work will take place. As you can see, the rest of the tools immediately become unlocked in the drop-down menu once the terrain area is set. By double-tapping on the terrain contour, I access the editing mode and can change the contour. I'll stick with a simple rectangle for now. If I switch to the 3D view, you will see that the terrain is actually a flat surface at the moment. It happens because points that form the terrain contour were not assigned elevation yet. To add an elevation, select the terrain contour and open the Object Properties tab of the inspector. This is where I add elevation for terrain contour points. For example, to create a simple slope incline from the right to the left, I need to add elevation to points 1 and 4. Say 2 feet. And here's what I get. As you may guess, the terrain contour can have as many contour points as you need, and each of them can have different elevations. In real life, the terrain rarely has such a plain surface. Usually it has some bumps and depressions. In our next video, you will explore how to create more complex terrain models.